The offset function is a great function for financial modeling. It's quite a difficult one to explain conceptually, so the easiest way to understand it is just to see what it does. So firstly, what it does is it allows you to tell Excel to start at a cell and move left or right, up or down, and tell you what's in that cell. So for example, if we've got some product sales here in some months, we want to start here. And depending what we put in these rows and columns, we want it to go to the right or down. The actual function itself is fairly simple. It's called offset. And what you'll see is the three components we're going to work with at the moment are here. It first asks for a reference. So I'm going to tell it to go stand in that cell over there. It then wants to know how many rows it should move up or down. If you put a zero there, it means stay still. If you put a negative number, it means go up. Positive number means go down. We're going to refer to this cell so we can play with it just now. Similar with columns, if I put a zero in the columns, it means stand still. If I put a positive number, it means go to the right. Negative number, go to the left. So I'm going to tell it to look in there. For now, we're going to leave height and width. We'll explain those later. When I say OK, you'll see it tells us 100. What Excel has done is gone, stood there, gone 0 rows up or down, 0 columns left or right. If we change the rows to a 2, for example, and maybe the columns to a 1, notice it says 1,400. What it's done is it's gone, stood in the 100, gone 2 rows down, 1, 2, one column to the right, 1, and it's telling you what it sees in that cell. Now this coloring here is something we've added on just to show you how it's working. Unfortunately, it does not happen when you actually use the offset function. So why would you ever need that? Well, for especially things like working capital, it's quite useful to be able to go backwards and forwards to see what happened in the future or in the past. So here's a practical example. We've got a whole bunch of products. We know we need to deliver 100 items in month 6. We've just built a little if function here, which tells us when each product needs to be delivered. Then we know we need to start manufacturing. And we know for product 1, we need 1 month to manufacture. Product 2, 2 months, etc. What we can do is create an offset function that looks like this. And what you'll see it's doing is it's saying go, look at stand in that cell there, and then go forward whatever you see in that cell there. So effectively Excel's saying I'm going to stand here, go 1 month forward. If I see anything there, we better start making it here. So you'll see here the 2 months forward, this one stands in that cell, it goes 1, 2, and because it needs to deliver something here, it knows it needs to manufacture it here. So you can quickly see that this nicely spread out sales forecast is actually going to be a hectic operational forecast. The benefit of this is if you decide actually product 1 now takes 2 months, when I put a 2 in there, you can see immediately it moves to that line there, because what it's now doing is, remember this function said go there, go 1, 2, so that's a 0. This one, which is a copy, says go there, go 1, 2. So the offset function can be very useful in those type of situations when you've got time issues and you want to move backwards or forwards in a financial model. There is another aspect to offset which is extremely, extremely useful. So I'm just going to go down a little bit lower. And what you'll see here, we've got again our sales, different products in the months. And I want to be able to add up different combinations. So for example, I want to add up maybe 3 months worth of product A sales. Maybe I change my mind and I now want 3 months worth of A, B, and C sales. But I want to control it within the spreadsheet. I don't want to have to go here and change my sums. Just before we do this, I just want to show you something else. If I say equals, and I want to sum these up, when I click enter, you'll see it says 100. So why, what I wanted to do was to look at those and sum it. Why didn't it do it? The reason it didn't do it is because we didn't tell it what to do. In this formula, we forgot the sum. So what we should have gone is said sum, open bracket, close bracket, and then it'll do it. Just keep that in mind with what I'm about to show you. So what we can tell Excel with the offset function is, if I go and find it again, the reference is exactly the same. Please go stand there. How many rows do you want to move up and down? I'm just going to look there. How many columns left or right? I'm going to look there. Then we've got an option of height and width. Height and width differs from rows and columns in the sense that height and width is the same as me clicking on individual cells. Height and width is the same as me clicking, holding, and dragging. So when you create a height, you're saying do something like that. So tell Excel, highlight those cells and do something with them. A width is like that, whereas the rows and columns are like that. So just repeating the process. I'm going to say go look at that cell there, please. That many rows, that many columns. For the height, if you enter something, you'll see you have to enter a 1. Same with the width. It cannot be a 0. You can leave it blank, but it cannot be a 0 because a range cannot be 0. It cannot be on the grid line. It has to be at least 1 high and 1 wide. So now we've done that. When I say OK, it tells us 100. If I say OK, I want a width of maybe 5, it still tells us 100. Why is that? Well, effectively what we've done with Excel is what happened up here. We've said this offset function has just done that part. What hasn't been, Excel hasn't been told yet, what must it do with that range? So just like over here, I put a sum. Over here around the offset, I need to put my sum or NPV or IRR or any other function. So when I say enter, you'll see it says 1500. What it's doing is it's standing here, going 0 rows and 0 columns. It's got a height of 1, so that's that one there, and a width of 5. I can tell it actually have a height of 3 perhaps. You'll see now what it's doing is coming to 13,500 because it's adding those up. Again, it stands here, it goes 3 high, 5 across, and that's what it's highlighting. We can also use the rows and columns, so I'm going to actually say go 1 row down, and you'll see it has an impact of starting here, going 1 row down, then highlighting 3 high, 5 across, and giving us our number. So where would we use this? There are lots of uses, and some of them will be covered in other areas, but here's a practical example. What we want to do is we want to have a rolling average of how much we need to deliver in the next X months, and the X can change. Maybe it's 3 months, maybe it's 6 months, etc. So I've created my delivery schedule, and this is telling me that at this point in month 4, in the next 3 months we need to deliver 100. We're in month 5, the next 3 months would be the 250, etc. So to create that, very simple, I go create my offset. I tell it to go look here. Rows and columns, I'm going to say just stay where you are. Height, you can either leave, but I'm going to put a 1 in it. Width, I'm going to say please go forward 3 months, whatever's in that cell there. When I say OK, giving me a straight answer, don't forget, all you've told Excel is that. You haven't yet told it what to do, so we must put a sum around it. And now what you've got is you've got a rolling average. At each point in time, you can see what the next 3 months will look like. If I put a 6 there, for example, what's now happening is it's starting here and going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And so it keeps rolling. And in fact, you can even go minus 3. And what you'll see, this goes backwards now. So it's going to tell you what you've delivered in the last 3 months. So that goes 1, 2, 3. This one here goes 1, 2, 3. So this is a very, very easy, practical way to be able to look forward and look back and effectively do what you would do manually, highlighting different areas, but doing it in such a way that's built into your actual spreadsheet.